You know, God created original products. Each and every one of us have our own fingerprint, our own voice print that no other on planet Earth matches up to yours. And going with that, I just wanted to say that what this world considers important, it tries to bundle up everybody into believing the same thing. You know, you're an original product. You know, I want you, okay, to create your own importance of what you consider important, okay? Because I know that the world considers Bentleys and Rolls Royce at the top of the material things, and it puts other things like mansions and this and that as the most important thing. The problem with this is that it's a rat race. Some people have it. Those people are the lucky ones, quote unquote, living the high life, so to speak. And the other day I saw a Rolls Royce in the parking lot. It's got four wheels. It's got a motor, speedometer. What am I trying to say? It's a car. And when you look inside of this fantastic utopia that they try to make it out to be, when you look inside, it doesn't have this ecstasy that they try to sell you. They try to sell it to be more than a car. It's an experience. You gotta have it. What am I trying to say? I'm using the car, but I'm really referencing to life in general. Like, it's a programming, you know? And the problem with all that programming is that if you find yourself in the bottom of the bucket, so to speak, you're always going to be looking to the top. The celebrities, the people that soak up, a lot of them are sounding off the alarm. A lot of them, not just one or two or three, a lot of them, most of them are sounding off the alarm saying, you know, we're not happy people, you know? It's not all that in a bag of chips. Why? Because we all live in the same earth. I want to pop the illusion and the delusion that they have more than what you have in terms of, it's like the house that they live in. It's a bigger box, as an example. The ocean that they go to, the beach, it's got sand and water, just like yours. I don't know if I'm doing it justice, but my whole thing that I'm trying to do here is I'm trying to get people to get out of the programming that television tries to create, TV tries to create, that everybody that's on TV has this made life and they're living this awesome life, and then people idolize them as a result. That right there, my friends, I would say that that's witchcraft. I would say that that's a spell. That it's not based on reality, rooted in truth. It's not. I've made videos that these same celebrities that have all this hype, they get sick, they go through mental illness, they check themselves into rehab, they have loved ones dying, they have mistakes, errors, and accidents. They have to go to traffic court, you know, when they get tickets. They have to, you know, some of them land in jail. They do time. So it's an illusion that they are living on a separate planet of yours. And, you know, money does make life easier. I'm not going to say it doesn't. Obviously, it does. You know, you don't have to worry about what you're going to eat the next time. You could eat the finer foods, etc. So in that respect, then yes. But in every other respect, then no, they're just human beings, just like you. They got blood, veins, and organs, and some of them fail, some of them, you know, whatever the case may be. So, back to you being an original product, you know, get out of the system, the simulation or the system or the programming that says that you have to think like how the whole system tells you to think. Create your own importance. Create what's important to you. Create what's, you know, and notice how the devil works. He makes fun of people that are different, right? The devil wants everybody, like, together. Understand that if everybody had creativity, which everybody's born with creativity, if everybody was exercising and activating their creativity, making the world a better place and just having creative thoughts, and they wouldn't be scared to bring it up and to innovate and to pursue their creativity. Because what happens all too often, they're made fun of, they're scoffed, they're like, you know, and all that. That's not people, that's a demon inside the person trying to squash a good idea. Often being talked out of it, you know what I mean? But so many people out there, man, you got gifts, you got talents, you know, and you're scared to utilize it because it's different than what the world has seen. But all the great celebrities that you see today are people that got to the end of themselves and they decided that people weren't worth the all that control over them. You know, they were giving away way too much of themselves over to people, and in the end of the day, those people were very judgmental. They didn't really have the value that made them gods over that person, right? They had flaws, they were hypocrites, and so these are the people that I'm trying to put myself in a box for. You know, these are the people that I'm saying, you know, they're saying red light and I have to stop. No, Arnold Schwarzenegger said it like this. He said, don't break the law, but break the rules. You know, you wanna make it, you wanna grow, you gotta step out of the box. There's paradigms that we have up here since we were young that people said, do this, do this. Now, I'm not talking about order. Obviously, order is a good thing, you know. We want red lights. You know, I'm at a red light right now. We want that because that's order. But I'm talking about control of the mind and what's, okay, as an example, what's in fashion. You know, create your own fashion. You know, that's breaking the rules, not the law. You know, create your own fashion. Stand out in your own way. You know, don't be secluded to just following what everybody else is doing because you don't want to stand out. You were made to stand out. Look at your fingerprint. Look at your voice print. These are things that make you stand out. Like nobody else has it like that. So you're rich with talent and gifts. And just understand that it's an illusion that people... Okay, so the way it works is that in the very beginning, people will criticize you. But those same critics, as you pursue, they'll become your biggest fans because you broke the barrier of their control. So then if they can't control you with criticism, they want to try to control you as being a fan. But in the end of the day, it's a control issue. And you just have to break free of other people's control over your life. Because this whole thing, for whatever reason, control is the theme, you know? I want to control what you think, what you see, what you hear, what you say. And I'll use fear, intimidation, all kinds of different things, different devices to try to get you to follow along to the trend of this world. And if you truly want to be happy, if you truly want to be satisfied, then you gotta follow your heart. You gotta follow you. Like, okay, when I'm saying follow your heart, I mean like your aspirations, your dreams, your visions might be different than everybody else's, and other people are, most of the time, they don't agree, they don't understand your dream and your vision. That's why I made a separate video and I said it, and I talked about keeping it to yourself and just doing it. Let people celebrate you after the fact, but don't share prematurely your dream and then you never get to accomplish it because you were talked out of it and you were made fun of, and etc. You know, it's all about control. For whatever reason, a lot of people have demons that want to control everything, just everything. So break out. Just break, break free and be completely free to do what you want. Not what you want in breaking the law, but break the rules. You know what I mean? Make it a positive, not a negative thing. Obviously, right? Positive breeds more positivity. Negative breeds destruction, hell, and guilt, shame, condemnation. So we're gonna stay away from the negativity. But if you know how to play piano and you know how to put a beat behind it, like no one else has ever done, but you're scared because it's different than anybody has ever done this. You have an idea that revolutionizes music. There's people that don't step out and do it because it's so different than what everybody else has ever created and done before them. And they're scared that they're gonna be like the oddball out. And to that I say, look at your life now. Look at your life now and diagnose your life. Is it really that? Are you really being celebrated that much now? That many pats on the back, that many hugs and that many kisses and that many, you know, like people bowing down to you kind of thing and say, oh, my king, oh, my queen. No, none of that is happening right now, most of it. So it's like, what are you giving up? Like, you're giving up your happiness, to keep people from talking either negatively or super positively. Stop caring. Stop, like, cut that off. Understand that people have opinions, but that's all it is. It's an opinion. And often they try to make their opinions sound like a statement or a fact. But in the end of the day, it's just an opinion. And once upon a time, I had somebody tell me something that was negative about who I was. And this was already when I had identity. So identity kicked in. And they kept saying something. I forgot what it was, but it was negative. That I was this. And I forgot what it was. Because it didn't matter to me. That's why I forgot, because I didn't take it in. I didn't receive it. But I remember it being negative. And they kept saying it, like almost like trying to affirm me that that's the truth. And you know what I responded back with? It's so liberating. I said, that's your opinion. And then I repeated it. That's your opinion of me? That's your opinion? And then they responded back by saying, yes. I said, okay, that's your opinion. That's your view. That's what you think. That doesn't mean that the cosmos aligned and the universe. I don't believe in the universe being God, by the way. I'm making an example that, oh, everything just came to be, was still, everything aligned and said, this is true, and the gavel came down and now I am that. No, but that's how people take it when they hear something like that. From somebody else, it's like, oh, they said this, so it must be true. No, that's their opinion, and most times it's a lie. So separate yourself from what other people are telling you that you are, okay? If it's not positive, then rebuke it, you know? Stand up for yourself in the sense of knowing that you have value and that you're expensive and that you're going places. You're going places and they're just mad that you're not within their control. So they're trying to control you with their labels and this and that, because you're moving. You're moving ahead of them, and they're saying, okay, gotta bring them back over here because they're outgrowing me. They're outshining me, you know? And so, that often happens when people are going to school and whatnot. You know, you've been hanging out in the neighborhood, you know, and all of a sudden, you know, you want to go back to school. And then, you know, like, at least for me, when I got saved and I started walking with God and started going after Jesus Christ, I was made fun of by my so-called friends And they would nickname me Pastor. Hey, Pastor, how you doing, Pastor? You know, I was fresh in the faith. I had just found God. God had done a unique, awesome work in my life to where he saved me from death and hell and destruction and darkness and negativity. And I was beginning to walk this thing out. And guess what? The control came. Oh, we got to bring him back. Let's use manipulation tactics like calling him a nickname so that he can bend. So that he can bend and say, well, I don't want to be called that. So, hey, can I come back, guys? You know, can you be good to me again? Can you be nice? You know, don't call me that no more. I don't want to be made fun of. So I'll be whatever you want me to be. It's nonsense. Well, let them say whatever they want. You don't have to receive it. You don't have to take it in. And that's the point. Once you acknowledge that you don't have to receive it, you don't have to take it in, that people could do whatever they want, say whatever they want, have, hey, okay, but, you know, don't touch me. No, that's a different thing. When you physically assaulted, that's another thing. But you can, hey, you can do it. You can do whatever you want. You know what I'm saying? Because I know who I am, and I know where I'm going, and I got something special. I got Jesus Christ, and he's taking me somewhere. And he is my source, right? I'm connected to him, and out of being connected to him, I'm getting everything that I need. And I don't need this world. I don't need the things of this world, right? Jesus Christ is feeding me all the identity I need, all the peace I need, all the joy and happiness and satisfaction, and he's taking good care of me. And so, if somebody doesn't like me, hey, I'm gonna keep on smiling. And I'm gonna go and buy you some empanadas. I'm gonna buy you a Gatorade. I'm gonna pat you on the head and say, hey, God bless you. You know what I mean? Whether you hate me, like me, or whatever, it doesn't matter. Because it doesn't affect me anymore. Once upon a time it did. I cared so much what other people thought of me. And now, I wasted a lot of my years and time and energy caring for what other people thought. And the illusion popper was when you figure out that those same people that you care, man, those people are screwed up individuals, man. They're so screwed up in so many different ways. And it's like, why do I care what you think? Look at your life. Look at your life. I mean, as an example, you're a drug addict, you're an alcoholic, you're a mess, you know? You got nothing going for yourself, and you're saying that I'm this, and you're making me have a bad day because you said I'm this, and now all of a sudden I'm entertaining what you say I am. Man, I kid you not, man. You know, I made another video. I said, consider the source. You know, consider the source. That's the end of the video, guys. God bless.